Hi everyone, welcome to my channel and welcome to today's video. I hope you guys are having an awesome day so far. It's quite early in the morning when I'm filming this video. It's around 10 o'clock. I usually don't film during this time, so it's a little unusual for me. But anyways, today I'm going to share with you my Durga Puja shopping haul, the first part. So in this video, I'm going to share with you all the skincare and the makeup stuff which I bought recently. Some of them I have been eyeing for a really long time and I have finally got them. So I'm going to share them with you. And some are usual skincare stuff which I want to get. So yeah, without much further ado, let's get started with today's video. Okay guys, so I think we should start quickly because there are a lot of things in front of me and yeah, I don't want this video to be too long. Anyway, so I got a few high-end stuff and some drugstore stuff. It's all mixed together. So the first thing which I want to share with you is this serum which I got. This is the Asano Rose Hip Serum. And this is how the box is, and this is a color which attracted me very much. It's a really nice pretty pink color. I haven't really used this serum or opened the box. This is the first time I'm opening the box actually, and this is how it looks. So this product is from New Zealand, I believe, and it's a serum which is enriched with plant peptides and it helps in revive, nourishing and regenerating. And yeah, this is a rose hip oil serum. So really interested to try this. I haven't really used a rose hip oil serum before and I have seen this product since a long time in Watson's. Watson's is a local drugstore here, but I never got this. It's around $39 or so, or $29, I'm forgetting. But there was a discount, so I thought that I should grab that opportunity and get this serum. I was eyeing that for a long time, so I got that. Then I got a few of these simple stuff. So the simple brand which is really good. So this is a mask which I got from Simple, and this is, I believe, the deep cleaning mask. So this is the deep cleaning mask and this is how it looks. I really like the packaging of these simple products, and these are from UK. So this product has the goodness of vitamins, pro vitamin B5, vitamin E and skin loving ingredients of natural clay, seaweed extract visible. So I'm really excited to try this. This was around $9 or so and there was a discount on this as well. So that is what I got next. I like to get all the stuff when there is a drugstore discount going on here. I usually stock up on things. Then this is the next thing which I got. This is the simple makeup cleansing wipes. This is the other variant. I have used one other variant. That one was really nice. This one is with zinc and chamomile and it is supposed to give you a spotless skin, quick fix cleansing wipes, and it removes waterproof mascara as well. So I'll let you guys know how this cleansing wipes are. Then I got some skincare from Sephora as well, and this is their Caudalie cleansing oil, and this is how it looks. Caudalie is a sort of a high-end brand and this was around I believe $35 or so, or $30. Anyways, I used my 10% off coupon or discount or whatever and I got this for a little less. And this is the cleansing oil. I have used their micellar water, the Caudalie micellar water. It is amazing. It is one of my favorite. I think that's the best micellar water I have tried. I have it currently as well. I have the smaller size. So this one is the cleansing oil which I wanted to try. So I got that. The next product I got was my Pixi Glow Tonic. So this is how it looks. I think I have spoken about this recently a lot on my channel, so I don't want to speak too much about it. I have a smaller bottle. This is a bigger one I got, and this has 5% glycolic acid and it is an exfoliating toner. I love this product. This toner has made me a believer of toners. Probably I'll not use any other toner. I will just keep using this, but I love this toner. This one actually works. When you use this, your skin just feels so clean. I mean, it just, I think there's a visible difference. So I love this stuff. I'll continue to repurchase this as long as I don't find something which is more affordable, because I have used a lot of affordable toners. They don't seem to work. I mean, I don't know. I haven't found such a great toner in the affordable range. Then from Sephora, I got two brushes. So these are, this one is a Sigma brush. This is the large shader brush. And this is the E60 brush. I don't know if you can see, this is a Sigma E60 and this is the brush like this. So I wanted to get these flat kind of brushes. This is supposed to be a dupe of MAC 242. I'm not really sure, I don't have MAC 242. These kind of brushes are good for your shimmer eyeshadows. So as you guys know, I apply my shimmer eyeshadows with my fingertips. That's how I like it. And also because I don't really have a brush to apply those kind of eyeshadows, so I thought let me just go ahead and invest in a brush which can do my shimmer eyeshadows. So I got this, let's see how it works. And I got one more brush for that purpose, and I got the Zoeva cream shader brush, and this comes in a box like this, which is really nice. And I got the rose golden brush. This is the 233 cream shader brush, and I love that Zoeva brushes come so nicely packaged. They will have a cap like this for the brush, and this is something like this. This is also a flat shader brush. I got it specifically for applying shimmer shadows. So let's see. I applied some with this and I quite liked it. But yeah, I was hoping for something more. But let's see, I'll just use it some more. So those are the skincare and makeup tools gone. Now I have some makeup which I have got recently. So let me just show you. I have got a lot of powders recently, and these powders are from various places. All are drugstore. So the first one is the Freedom powder which I got. This is translucent and this is how it looks. So this one is recommended by my friend here on YouTube, Anjana, and this is how it looks. I quite like it. I have been using this. So this is the translucent one. Then I got one more powder. This is the Wet n Wild Photo Focus powder, and this is in the shade Tan Beige, and I really like this powder. I've used this today as well, and I really like it. It has a very nice soft focus kind of a finish. And this is the powder. I like the packaging as well. I'm planning to do a Wet n Wild one brand kind of a tutorial, so I'll use this and demo this out. And I got one more powder. All my current powders I have hit pan, so I think they are not picking up the product so much, so that's why I got some new powders to try. And this is from the brand called Zaa, Z-A-Z-A. This is a Korean brand, I think, or Taiwanese, I'm not really sure. Yeah, it's made in Taiwan. This is quite popular here in Singapore and in the Southeast Asia. And this is a drugstore brand, and there was a sale, so I picked it up. And this is the powder shade. This is how it looks. I haven't really used it. There is a film on top of it. This is how the color is. I really like the color. They had a lot of shade range. So this is a smooth microfine powder, provides a delicate veil without clogging pores, and it gives a beautifully natural and radiant finish. So that's what I look for in my powders. I don't really like a lot of mattifying powders, so that's why I got this, because this is supposed to give you a radiant finish, and the Wet n Wild also gives a radiant kind of a finish, so that's why I got these. Then some exciting new stuff from the makeup world. This is the palette which I got from the balm, and this one I got from Color It in Singapore here. I will link it down, whatever I can link, I will link. So this is from Color It, and I got this for around $50. They were having a discount. This is the original price is around $65 or $70 or something. It's quite expensive, I agree, but I want to try a balm face products, because I don't really have these kind of face products. These blushes, I have heard really good things about balm blushes. I did not have those, so it's a nice way to try all the products. You get a lot of things. Anyways, I have a full review and tutorial on this. I think it will be already up on the channel by now. So I will link it down below. You can go ahead and check it out so you can see the review. The next thing which I got is from Sephora. This is a sample size from Fenty Beauty. So I had ordered some stuff from Sephora, so I got this sample from Fenty Beauty. And this is their Pro Matte Foundation, the Soft Matte Foundation. And this is in the shade 340. And yeah, they did not have the shade 310 for sample. So I think that will be a nice match for me. This one is too deep, too dark. So yeah, if you're close to my skin tone, 340 is going to be too dark, but I'm still going to keep it around. Probably if 310 is too light, then I will need this one to mix it up. So that's a good one I have. The next thing which I got is, I have been wanting this for so long. So this one I had seen while I was going to Beijing. So this one is the Urban Decay Afterglow Highlighting Palette, and this is how it looks, and it's a highlighting palette. It has four highlighters. This is so gorgeous. So I had seen this when I was going to Beijing. I had seen it in the airport. And yeah, I buy all my Urban Decay stuff at the airport. They come a little cheaper. So I had seen this and I had picked some other stuff, so I did not buy this. But it has been so long and I kept on thinking about this palette. So I thought, okay, let's just finally buy it. because I obsess about things too much. And at the airport I had loved it so much, so I finally decided to buy it. So this one is the Afterglow palette by Urban Decay. I really love the packaging. It's a cardboard packaging and this is how it looks. I will do a full review on this, so I'm not going to do too much today. And these are the highlight shades in this. This is how it looks. It is so pretty. I don't know why it's looking so light here, probably because of my exposure of the camera. This is how it looks. So these are like nice shades for my skin tone. If you're close to my skin tone, tan skin tones will really get a lot of use out of this palette. This pink shade probably I'll not use that much, but these three shades are amazing. The quality is really good. I really love it. These are really soft highlighters. I will review this palette separately, but I just want to show you in my haul today. And then I have a few eyeshadow palettes. Two I'm going to show in this video, and some have not yet arrived, and for them I'm anyways going to do separate videos, so I'm not going to do a haul for them. So the first eyeshadow palette is this one. This one is the Colored Rain Queen of the Hearts eyeshadow palette. And this is how it looks. Look at the packaging. It is so beautiful. I have been waiting for this eyeshadow palette for so long. It has been so long. I have been obsessed with this one after I have watched so many reviews of how amazing this eyeshadow palette is, how beautiful the shadows are, how pigmented and creamy. I mean, people have been raving about this. So I just wanted to get this. This was out of stock for a long time. Now it has returned as a permanent palette. So now you can get it anytime. Earlier it was a limited edition. So let me show you the inside. This is how the shadows are. This is how the shadows are. Oh my god. Look at the shadows. Those are like all the dream shadows I would ever need. Like, this is my perfect palette. Everything I would need is in here. Everything I would need is in here. Probably a matte black is not there, but that's okay. All the colors are just amazing. I have swatched it and the quality is just amazing. I mean, the shimmers and the mattes, they are just so good. So this one I got from Beauty Bay. It was pretty expensive. If you are in the US, it's around $50. And yeah, you can get it at much cheaper if you're in US. But I got it from UK, from Beauty Bay. It was around $80. But yeah, I don't regret spending so much on it, because I have been wanting this palette for more than 6-7 months. And the next one which I have is an Impulse Buy. This is from NYX. And this is the Ultimate Multi Finish Shadow Palette. I have been wanting to get this since a long time. And I finally got the Urban Decay palette. But this is very similar to Urban Decay palette. So I just want to try this, that how similar it is. I will do a video comparing the two. So I got this. I was passing the NYX store that day. And I did not know that this has released in Singapore. I was seeing this online on Cult Beauty and other places. But I did not know it has already released in Singapore. And that day I saw near the NYX store that it's on display, like it just in front when you enter. And so I just went ahead, picked it up and paid for it. So yeah. That's a total impulse buy. I will do a video on this soon. Okay, next are some lip stuff which I've got. So this is the first one which I got. There was a discount, so I got it. So this one is the Le Matte L'Oreal Paris lipstick. And these are matte lip crayons. And this is how it looks. This is so good. I have the shade 102 She's So Matte. I'll just swatch it here. So this is the lip shade. It's a very pretty everyday pinky nude kind of a shade. This is how it looks. Really nice. This one I got influenced by Bhumika, if you guys know, from Makeup and Smiles. I really liked her review and she has reviewed this on her blog. The next two lipsticks I got are the Lip Lingerie lipstick from NYX. So I got this along with the Ultimate palette. So this is around $15 and I have never tried a Lip Lingerie matte lipsticks. And I just want to try the formula, so I just got one nude kind of a shade, like everyday shade which I will wear. So that's what I got. I haven't really opened this as well. It's a really nice nude shade. Let me just swatch it. So this is how it looks. That is the NYX Lip Lingerie shade. Bang bang. I haven't really read a lot of reviews about this. I know there are a lot of videos on this, but I have never been interested in this once, so I don't know, I'm really interested to try this. And the other liquid lipstick I got is from Wet n Wild, and I already have a few of them, and I have picked up a few for giveaway as well. And this one is in the shade Nice to Fuchsia, and I really like the formula of these Wet n Wild lipsticks. These are so good. I will do a video soon. I was planning to do a video since so long. This is how it looks. So that's the shade Nice to Fuchsia. I hope you can see. So that's the shade. So that's it guys, those are all the products I have got, and this is not a one day haul or anything. I have been buying products on and off, and I think the sun is getting too bright, and so I should just quickly end the video here. So I really hope you enjoyed all the products I have got. I will review them, most of them, on my channel, so you'll get to know. If you want me to review something first, then do let me know. And yeah, as always, if you like this video, then don't forget to give this video a thumbs up. And also, if you are watching me for the first time, I really hope you consider subscribing. And yeah, thank you so much for watching. I will see you guys really soon in my next video. Bye.